From the high desert and the great American Southwest, I bid you all good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you may be in God's great universe. Welcome to Midnight in the Desert. This is a test. Had this been an actual emergency, you'd have been instructed to put your head between your legs and, well, you know. Ah, yes. Well, everybody, here we are. All this time, all this waiting, all this amazing waiting. It's been, I've got to tell you, it's been really, really hard on me. My heart is good. I know that much. Or by now, I would have, well, stroked out or had a heart attack or something. All the waiting's been killing me. I'm glad to be back on the air. It is a pleasure to be back with you all. I have so much that I've got to say, and that I'm about to say, which will help you get into the show. The first great rule that this show has is no bad language. No bad language. We don't need it. We have listeners of all ages, 8 to 80. And, of course, if a bad word comes sailing through, Mom and Dad get upset and they shut it off right away. I certainly would. Now, I'm going to move through a few things that I want you to know about very much. Number one, I have these people to thank, and then we'll go into the how to get into the show part. Tonight is an amazing night, and you wouldn't believe how much had to happen for all of this to be happening right now. And this is, again, just a test. But to make this happen, so many people have helped, and I'll start with Telos. It's an amazing story. The gear that gets the show from here to there, the gear that creates telephone lines from internet for me, and that hopefully makes it sound good, and I hope it does sound good, are provided by a company called Telos. And one day I called Telos, you know, inquiring to spend a lot of money. And the gal at Telos said, the fellow, the chief engineer, the big guy for Telos, lives in Pahrump, Nevada. And I went, no. Turns out it's a fellow named Joe Talbot, and he fixed me up big time, more than just me. So this new equipment that sends out what's called a 48-kilobit AAC signal. We've got both AAC and MP3, but here's the cool thing about AAC. It actually sounds as good, the 48 AAC, as, you know, 120, 128, like that. So, thank you, Telos. Thank you, Joe Talbot. Keith Rowland, my webmaster, my buddy of, I don't even know how long it is now. Probably 25, 30 years, something like that. My webmaster, he'll be the guy running the breaks, doing stuff like that. Dr. J, my new producer. Paul is no longer my producer. He has he's worked his way up in the world, and I won't say what he's doing, but he's well. And my good friend Paul, as a matter of fact, I should add, very many years also. Dr. J, the producer, all of you out there, could not have been done without all of you. Now, this is a free program. This program goes out, you know, to everybody. And you don't have to pay for it. But if you want to become a, what we call a time traveler, then you can pony up $5 a month. And for that, boy, you get all kinds of cool stuff. You get to download the show anytime you want, and that includes old shows, not the one we just did, but old shows. Presumably we get them. you also get what's called, and you know I should bring that up right now, it's called the wormhole. And so when you send a question to the wormhole on my website, That question is then piped directly to me, and I'm bringing it up right now. I should have done this earlier in the show. There it is, the wormhole. And so you can send me all kinds of really cool questions. And, you know, if I've got a guest, you can ask a question. And if I think it's a good question, believe me, I will ask the guest. The next group I want to thank is the Belgab website. These are incredible people. Now, the Belgab website, that's B-E-L-L-G-A-B. The Belgab, you might look it up on the web and go check it out. These are people that are, how do I characterize them? They are energetic, a little cruel at times, but definitely vaguely lovable. So the Belgab gang deserves a great big thank you. Thank you. They did a lot of promotion for the show, way more than they should have done, and thank you. Matter of fact, they were even responsible for getting the show promoted in Times Square, New York. So there you have it. Now, next, the guys who get the show to you, hopefully without incident, are called the stream guys. When you initially clicked, you probably heard a little, I don't know, promotion for stream guys. They've got the servers that are sending out the show to all of you. And then finally, God bless them, LasVegas.net. Doing a show by internet, and I am doing it by internet. Everything is internet. My phones, the transmission of the show itself, all my computers, my Skype connections, all of that. It's all by internet. So I live and die by internet, which is why I'm worried about all the storms out there. Now, fortunately, they have not rolled in yet tonight, but I want to serve up warning if they do, and if power should go out. Oh, please, power, don't go out. That would be it for me. I'd be off until the power came back and LasVegas.net got back on. So we are internet dependent in so many ways. That's kind of the list, I think, of people I want to thank. Now, I would like to talk to you about how to call the show, and that's the purpose of the program tonight. No guest tonight, although I may bring a mysterious young gal on here after a while. That aside, though, no guest. And so there are various ways you can call the show. I'm going to give you our public number. It is area code 95. Are you writing this down? 952-225-5278. Or if you wish, 952-CALL-ART. Probably have to put a 1 in front of it, you know. One in front of that. 1-952-225-5278. Then we have two other ways you can call. And we're going to be very strict about this. We have two Skype setups here, or I do. One is for the U.S. and Canada. Now listen to this one very closely. And write it down. If you're in the U.S. or Canada, you can reach us on Skype at MITD51. Doesn't matter whether it's caps or lowercase, MITD, Midnight in the Desert, MITD 51. That's for North America. Then, beyond that, you can call, if you're overseas, it doesn't matter where you are in the world, you can call us at MITD 55, MITD 55, all right? Now, I'm just going to sort of ramble around and take calls all over the place. I'm going to take public calls. I'm going to take Skype calls in North America and overseas. And I hope it all works. And that's the point of tonight's show, hoping that it all works. We did have a little bit of server difficulty earlier, but I think they've probably got that straightened out by now. Let it be so. And so open lines, anything you want to talk about, but here's what I would suggest. I would like you to tell me what you would like to have on the show. Does that make sense? What would you like to hear? What path? I mean, I've got my own, of course. You know me and time travel, right? I love it. So I'll go down that path, artificial intelligence, all the things I love. But I want to know from you where you want to go. Does that make sense? You tell me where you want to go, and I'll try and get there. So that's the deal. I suppose I'll have to go over this phone thing again, and I will right now very quickly. The public number is area code 952-225-5278. It's easy. Write it down. The Skype connect is, oh, yes. I guess I need to go over this. One more thing. Sound quality. How to get the best sound quality when you call. If you are on a computer, and yes, it's okay to use a computer, and you're on Skype, please, if at all possible, use a headset mic. That's right, a headset mic. Don't sit back 5 feet from the computer and yell at me. It always sounds like, well, like you're in a dungeon. So get a headset mic if you're going to use a computer, but there's a really cool trick. If you've got a smartphone, now, of course, I refer to an Apple product, one of the iPhone series, which, well, that's my personal preference. We can have a night when we argue about Android and Apple, or an Android, one of the lesser Android products, in my opinion. You can load Skype onto your phone. And once you've loaded Skype on your phone, it's a piece of cake. You don't have to be paid on Skype or anything like that. Just have Skype on your phone, folks. And it's just that simple. You attempt to make a call to me. We don't have to connect and be buddies. We don't have to have connections. You can just call. Once you have put in, if you're in North America, MITD 51, you can then go back to your list, and you'll see it in there, MITD 51, and you can call me. Same deal with everybody overseas. If you're overseas, MITD 55. Just put it in as though you're calling for a new contact. And even though I don't necessarily confirm you as a new contact, it won't matter. You can call me anytime you desire. And you will sound good. Really good. Because the quality, you know, coming from, I must admit, even Androids, is pretty good. So it's a great way to call the program. Okay. All that said, in a moment, we're going to return, and when we do, we're going to begin taking open line. Anything you want to talk about, calls. How does that sound? From the high desert to the great American Southwest, I'm Art Bell. We are going to rock the world tonight, and it's all up to you. This is a test show only. We're not going to have a guest, but hey, we've got all of you. And so I'm hoping that that you have lots to say. And as I said, if anything you want to say is fine. I mean, that's it. No call screener. I never screen calls. I don't believe in it. Screens out a lot of good stuff. And I mean all of you. If I screen calls, you know, I miss good stuff. I think some of the better stuff we've ever had, frankly, is, you know, if it had called some other show, it would have been screened out as, well, this one's a nutcase dump. And sometimes they are, but a lot of times they're radio gold, as I've been told. One last time, if I might, with the way to call, the public number is 952-225-5278. And then the two very important ones are Skype calls. In the North American realm, the U.S. and Canada, it's MITD 51. You can do it from your phone, folks, MITD 51, or your computer. And then overseas, anywhere outside North America, it's MITD 55. And I hope some of you out there, way out there, you know, in, I don't know, Japan, Thailand. It's kind of not a good time of night for Europe. It's something like 4 in the morning or 5 in the morning or something like that. Although I suppose somebody might have stayed up. So anywhere outside North America, you're going to have a pretty easy time because I'm keeping that line open for you. Outside North America, MITD 55. All right, I don't see any reason to delay. Remember, I want to hear from you what you want to hear. Let us go to the first line I punched and say, hello there, it's midnight, you're on the air.
Yeah. Really, I'm first?
You're first.
How exciting is this? I'd always kind of hoped that would happen. Thank you so much for coming back.
Okay, thank you for coming back with me. How about that? Where are you?
I am in Ohio.
Ohio. Okay, and your first name?
Jim.
Okay, Jim. How long have you been a listener of mine?
Oh, good Lord. Since the 90s? I used to listen to you in the garage at night when I would work, like 2, 3 in the morning. I'd be listening to you interview John Lear, and it was delightfully creepy. But it was one of those things where, you know, it's one of those formative memories where it's one of my favorite things I ever did was just kind of zen in the art of motorcycle maintenance and listening to Art Bell late at night.
Do you know what the creepiest thing John Lear ever said was?
What's that?
Well, I mean, you may have your own point of view on it. Maybe you don't. To me, he said, Art, if you die, don't go to the light. Go to the darkness.
Well, that's odd.
Yeah, that's odd. I mean, it's really odd. And now you are infected. Think about it. If you were to pass on, stroke out right now, and you saw the bright, shiny light over there, and Art Bell had just told you that John Lear said it's a trick and that you should go to the darkness, well, it's like you're infected now. You'll never forget this.
Actually, the one show you did have that did truly affect my my perspective of the afterlife, you had the, I think it was a French professor who was an atheist, who had the stomach problem while he was overseas and died.
Yes.
If that guy was acting, he was one of the best actors I've ever heard in my entire life. I mean, it was deeply moving. That was probably one of your best shows.
Well, thank you. May I ask you this, since you are, my first caller, how are you listening to the program?
I am using TuneIn Radio on an iPad.
A TuneIn Radio on iPad. Okay, how does it sound?
Sounds pretty great.
we are in stereo, by the way. So if you have earbuds or something like that, and it sounds like you're eating something, what are you eating?
Me?
Yes.
Oh, I'm not eating anything. I'm actually talking to you on a StarTAC cell phone.
Ah. Thank you. Okay, all right. Well, if you have earbuds or something like that, the stereo will come through.
Oh, that's great. But I do have a suggestion, a topic I would love for you to cover.
I'm listening.
I'm hoping you've seen it. There's a documentary called Zero Point, the Mark McCandless story.
Oh, yes. I know Mark.
Yeah, the kid that made it was murdered. And I mean, not like it's possible he was murdered, but like the kid was murdered. But the documentary is fascinating. But I've never heard anybody cover it. And I think it's probably more interesting.
You can be sure that I will cover my friend Zero Point. Thank you very much for the call. And that brings up another topic. I've got this long, gigantic loop. I've got about 5 acres of property out there, folks, and this gigantic loop that goes around 5 acres uses number 10 wire, produces voltage like you would not believe. I destroyed a lot of ham rigs before I figured out what it was. And I meant to save it. There was an article on the web about a company that is formed to produce energy from exactly what I've got. Actually, what they've got set up is a little smaller than what I've got right here. But it does produce energy. Now, how much current? How useful? Certainly for charging it can be used. Let me take a quick call overseas. I think it's overseas. You're on the air.
G'day, Art. Hello from Australia.
Good day, mate. Australia, eh?
That would be correct. You're speaking to James. It is currently 5 to 2 in the afternoon here. A beautiful day in sunny Adelaide Have you ever heard of Adelaide before?
Oh, of course.
Oh, you have?
Oh, yes. I've never been to Australia, but you're on my bucket list.
Well, you better come over here and kick that bucket, Mr. Bell.
Yeah, better hurry up, right?
We'd love to see you down here.
Tell me a little bit about living in Australia. Is living in Australia, you know, a dream come true? Is it wonderful there?
I'm going to be honest with you, Art, and say, yeah, pretty much it is. It is it's a sparsely populated continent. We have lots of space.
Uh-huh.
Our weather, well, where I am in South Australia, is quite good. It's in the middle of winter at the moment, so fairly cold. Our government at the moment, well, I think there's a lot to be desired for them.
They all leave a lot to be desired. So would you recommend that everybody in North America sell off their assets, mm-hmm. gather all their cash, and move right away to Adelaide?
Sure, why not?
Be honest now.
we could use some American brains of this state, and particularly that fellow who has invented the Tesla car. We've just, in the next year or so, our General Motors Holden factory will be closing, and if we could produce electric cars here in Australia, that would be a great boon to not only our country, but to the planet as well.
You're right about that. It'd be great. Boy, what a great... Yep. I must tell you, your connection is superb from Australia.
Oh, thank you, Mr. Bell. Well, I'm talking to you on Skype, as you may know. I've got a direct link and using a headphone stereo headset, which I normally use for gaming.
That's it.
And you said...
encourage them. Tell everybody how much better it sounds when you use a headphone mic.
Oh, it's great. I feel like I am talking to you on the phone, but I've got stereo, and I can hear you in my left and hear you in my right. I've got my hands free so I can continue to do what I'm doing at the moment, which is I'm supposed to be repairing some mobile phones because that's what I do. I work for myself as well.
Wait a minute. You repair mobile phones?
I do, yes. So,
you're an expert on mobile phones.
I am, yes. Broken screens, water damage.
Yeah. Oh, great.
You name it. I'm currently pulling a broken camera out of a Nokia and putting a new one in.
Okay. So in the great debate between Apple and Android,
yes,
where would you, as an expert, come down?
To be honest, I actually don't like both of them.
What?
I'm not a big fan of smartphones because they are so fragile. Now, that's my bread and bucket. Fixing them.
Yes.
But everyone out there, especially anyone who owns a phone, can sympathize that they have broken their screen at least once. They've dropped it. It's been in the toilet.
I don't know about the toilet.
They are fragile things. And you remember that, you know, 5 or so years ago when phones used to be robust and you could drop them off a third floor building bounce and you could still use them. You can't do that anymore.
Oh, I don't remember that day, actually. Most of my phones that have gone off third floor, they're toast.
You still there?
I haven't had one go in the toilet yet. Hello?
Hello?
Yes, it looks like we somehow lost connection.
Oh, I think I've lost the line.
Aw. I'm so sorry. You can't hear me? Hello?
I can barely hear you, so...
You can barely hear me? Oh, you hear me a little bit?
Sorry, you might have to go to another caller. I think I've lost audio.
Okay, well, here I was promoting, thank you very much. Here I was promoting everything like crazy, that it was going to work flawlessly, and, I get to rate this call. How would you rate that call? I'd say it's fair. What would you like to do? Anything, that's on your mind is fair game. Seriously. We'll go over the numbers again and how I would prefer you to call, but in the meantime, let me say hello there somewhere outside the country. You are now on Midnight. Hello?
Hello?
Oh, there you are.
Hi.
Hi.
How's it going?
It's going pretty well.
Good.
Thank you. Who have I got? Where are you?
I am Tracy. I'm in Saskatoon, Saskatchewan.
Now you're in North America, hon.
Yes.
So you're supposed to be calling the North American line.
Oh, okay. Ooh. I thought you said it didn't matter.
Well, no, it does.
The international call.
Oh, no, it does.
I'm sorry.
We have two categories. One is America and Canada. And we call that North America. And then everybody else. because everybody else, you know, has a hard time getting through. So if I would appreciate it if you call the right line, okay?
Okay.
Nevertheless, hello and goodbye, and thank you very, very much for calling. I do appreciate that, and we'll try this. Somebody who calls himself the Darkness 97. Darkness, are you there?
Hello.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi, Darkness.
My name's Mark.
Mark. So your name is not actually Darkness.
No, my name's Mark.
All right, Mark, where are you?
I'm in a place you may never heard of. It's called Vaux-en-Sea in North Wales.
Really?
In the UK, yes.
In the UK.
Yes,
if I might inquire, what time is it there, and why in the hell are you up at that time?
Well, I'm up at this time because I was waiting for you, and the time is 5:39.
Oh, my goodness.
In the
I really am impressed, and I'm honored that you would get up at that time. I wouldn't get up at that time for, well, I would not want to see the Pope, but you get the idea, right?
May I say, sir, it is an absolute honor for me to talk to you.
And for me to speak to you as well. So we have this new program. Number one, I'm curious, listening way over there in Wales, how does it sound? Does it sound okay?
Sir, you sound, Mr. Bell, you sound as if you were next door.
See, now, coming all the way from Wales, that's pretty cool. So that means that pretty much everything is working. That's what I'm going to be asking people. And another thing is, we're in stereo, so I'm encouraging people to use earbuds and they'll actually hear the stereo. It's kind of nice.
Yes, sir. I have, what I'm using to talk to you is actually a webcam mic.
Okay, well, you know, you can actually use a webcam mic well. And when I say well, that means grab the silly thing off the, you know, the monitor and get it near your lips so it's like you're talking into a microphone. If you do that, it's going to work pretty well.
I'm holding it right as close to my mouth as I can.
Good Wales person.
Yes, sir.
let's see, I guess I asked the fellow in Australia, so I'll ask you, should everybody move to Wales?
Well, if they like rain, yes.
If they're not what?
If they like wet weather, rain, definitely.
Well, we are in the drought-stricken part of the United States that is slowly going to dry up and blow away if we don't get moisture very soon now. I don't know if you've been hearing the news about it, but this is some kind of a global shift in weather, and I'm telling you, you know, I used to drive in the desert, and I would see cactus everywhere, and now the cactuses are crying.
Yes, sir.
Well, just sort of, they don't have really the moisture to cry, but they're, you know, they're upset.
Yeah.
What would you like to hear talked about on this program?
Oh, I don't know. I think you've covered a lot.
You mean I've done it all? There's nothing left I can do?
One thing that did interest me, you did it a long, long time ago now, when you were talking to Father Malachi Martin.
Oh, yes. Unfortunately, as you know, or maybe you don't know, Father Malachi Martin has passed away.
Oh, no.
Yes, I'm afraid so. In fact, the word is that he fell down some stairs. Now,
oh, dear Lord.
Oh, yes, dear Lord is right. And I am somewhat suspicious that, well, let's see, how can I put this? There are those who feel he might have been helped.
Oh, dear.
Oh, dear. Well, listen, thank you. Thank you for the call. I really, really appreciate it. And getting up this time in the morning, hey, if I could give you an award, I would do it.
It's been an honor, sir.
All right. Thank you so very much. By the way, I want to thank Leo Ashcraft. He is our newsman. And as you may have noticed, our news is, well, just a little bit different. We're doing relevant news. And one of the things that he covered that really caught my attention was consciousness. As you know, that is a eternally fascinating subject to me. And he seemed to suggest, with what he said, that consciousness is sort of the totality of our brains, right? He also seemed to suggest that it may be possible to download somebody's brain and upload it to somebody else's brain. Now, it may be too late for me. I'm 70, right? But some of you may have the opportunity to be, well, perhaps downloaded and stored until a body becomes available for you. And then they would just whisk you into a new body. Let's go to the phones and say, hello there. You're on the air, I think, in New York.
Yes. Hey, Art. Hi. It's Scott from the... And hello from the Fantastic Forum, your old friends.
Oh, hey, buddy. How you doing?
Doing great. It is fantastic to hear you again.
May I ask, are you listening critically? Does it sound okay?
It sounds fantastic. I'm actually using the new CC Wi-Fi, too.
All right.
And it's awesome. In fact, your station sounds better than just about all the others I've heard so far.
Oh, really? Oh, well, that's good
to
hear. Does the... Well, you're not wearing earbuds, so you don't know, but the stereo, I hope, is coming through.
Yeah, no, I have no idea with this radio. It's single speaker, but...
Oh,
it's
really?
Mono, but... Yeah.
Okay.
But it's fantastic. It sounds great.
Okay.
The AAC is legit.
Oh, it really is legit. It's an amazing... Yeah. I mean, it used to take 128 to produce this kind of audio, but now 48 AAC just kicks it away.
Yeah, absolutely. It's absolutely crystal clear. In fact, it sounds better than it did on the radio back in the day.
Cool. All right. Well, we're not on radio stations tonight. That I don't think, anyway. That'll be tomorrow. And starting tomorrow, we'll be on radio and shortwave.
Cool.
So tonight
I've got a
it's...
I have a guest request for you.
Yeah. Oh, I'm listening.
Robert Felix, if he's still around. With everything and the global warming pause and everything else, he talked about the Ice Age. It would be fantastic to hear him again.
All right, let me hear your opinion. We're going dry here in the American Southwest. I mean, it's really, really bad, buddy. It's really bad. If you look at the Lake Mead, Las Vegas is about to dry up and blow away. They're putting in what they call a lower straw, you know, to get more water out of Lake Mead, but it's going empty, you know.
Yep.
If this doesn't change, the American Southwest is going to have to pack their bags and go somewhere else.
And over here, we've just, I mean, late July, and we've just finally started cracking 90 degrees in New York.
Wow.
And that's just, it never happens. We just had a brutal winter. I mean, what's going on with the climate now is absolutely bizarre. And I'm starting to wonder, I mean, grew up thinking, you know, if we're going to get hotter, it's just going to keep getting hotter.
Mm-hmm.
And now I'm starting to wonder, do we have any idea what's going on? So he always had that different theory, and I'd be fascinated to hear what he thinks about what's going on, because none of the what do you call them, models seem to be turning out correct.
Well, I agree with you. I'm not sure what's going on myself. I know that the global temperature is going up, but I think it's producing all kinds of weird things, like stronger storms, people in the Maldives who are going to have to move because the ocean will come over them. My wife's family is in the Philippines. They're not real hot on what's going on. And we're not here in the Southwest, so something's going on. I wish they would figure it out and do something about it before it's too late.
Absolutely.
And I've got a feeling we're approaching too late pretty soon. Well, thank you for the call.
Thank you. It's great to hear you again.
Take care. All right, so this is a test night. I want to keep reminding everybody. I'm going to take off and just start doing a show here pretty quick if I haven't already started doing that. But it's a test night, so we want to know how everything sounds to you in general. Let's go to the, let's see, let's go to a domestic Skype call and say, hello, Joseph. You're on Midnight.
How are you doing tonight, Art?
Very well, and boy, do you sound good.
Ah, you do too. I'm going to tell you what, Keith has done an excellent job. The streaming is better than most of the stuff we listen to online. I'd like to point out from a flashback from the past, a truck driver named Joe, the original, and MJ and the rest of them on the people who have Art Bell page on Facebook all say hey.
Yeah, they've been big, big supporters, no question about it.
Yeah, we've been trying to look out for you.
Thank you.
Go ahead.
No, go. It's your call.
Well, you know, I just wanted to call in and do my own test on my end. And I don't know if you remember me from the past or not. We we never talked on the air before. I never really bothered with that. But
where are you, by the way?
Oh, I'm not in Southern Cal anymore. I'm up in Fresno now.
Fresno, okay. We're going to eventually be on the air, actually, on a Fresno station, by the way.
Yes, you are.
I think that it's going to take a little time. They've got a couple contracts that they've got to change around, but they're going to get us on.
Oh, okay. So they're still playing with the details.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, well, yes, we'll get it worked out, right?
Right. Oh, absolutely.
I hope the girls are doing well.
They are?
I was going to mention Mr. Lear as well, but the first caller did.
Mm-hmm.
You know what? Stick to what works, what you've always done.
Well, if you were to stroke out right now and leave us, same question, right? The lightness or the dark?
I don't know.
Come on, pick a direction.
That one always made me nervous, too.
Yeah.
It got my attention as much as it got yours.
Well, you know, when you die, I mean, you're going to see the light glowing. You're going to see probably the tunnel. You may see your relatives trying to lure you in the wrong direction.
Well, I'm a little bit of a traditionalist, so I'll probably go for the light.
You know what? I think I would, too.
Yeah.
And then when I get up there and I really see it, it could be the light of flame.
Sure. Oh, you know what? Something else I wanted to mention to you,
What's
too.
That?
Using Skype?
Yes.
You can have callers send you files and stuff as well.
Oh,
and if
please.
You turn the camera on, you can do video.
Oh,
like
what?
No,
I'm not going to do video. And I'm sure that I would see him come sailing in. Open this .exe.
Hey, you know what? That's something I want to congratulate you on, too.
What's that?
You know, some people don't understand. They don't follow this kind of stuff. They're fans of yours, but don't really follow radio and all that much. And this is a historical thing in radio history.
It is.
Because for people that are listening that don't realize it, once we got this going, and I don't know if you remember some of the ideas I threw your way too, which was a different version of what you ended up doing, but just along the same lines. You had radio stations contacting you and Keith.
Oh, this is utterly backwards.
Without any advertising or nothing.
Oh, yeah. It's backwards, my friend. Yeah. Absolutely. We're feeding radio stations, or will be, from the Internet. As far as I know, nobody does that.
I don't think so. Anyone's ever done it.
So that's a good reason to do it.
But, hey, you know what?
What?
You've always been the landmark.
Well,
first show to have a dedicated website, stream over the web, international 800 numbers, all this stuff.
Do you know that I began with, I'm afraid this dates me, but I began with a BBS.
Yeah.
A BBS. And people with 9,600 baud modems. then I graduated to a fax machine. That cost a couple of forests, I'm sure.
Uh-huh. It's more than a couple for us over the years. I remember those days of it running out of paper.
What would you like us to talk about on the show? You have any favorite topics?
I want you to stay the same genre.
Okay.
We need to find a little, I don't have any specific names in mind right now. We need to find a little bit of new blood, but all the same genre.
That's exactly what we're going to do.
Cubs and all that, they got the notoriety through you and the old show.
Okay.
Stuff like that.
All right, I'm good with all that. One question for you, if you don't mind. If you were about to pass, and they offered you the opportunity for your mind to be...
You're going to go there.
Yeah, I am. And you know, it would be stored until they had a body that you could be downloaded into, or uploaded.
If I was on my way out anyways, I'd probably go for it, what you got to lose. But I doubt the technology is going to be there for a long time to reanimate, however they're putting it now.
You got a lot to lose. I mean, all right, I'm going to move on. Thank you very, very much for the call. It is a really, really cool question, actually. And let's go over here and say hello. You're on the air.
Hi, Art.
Oh, I know this voice.
I certainly do.
Okay, you're a little heavy on the mic, Andy.
I'll stand back a little bit. How are you?
There you go. That's better. I'm doing really well. How do we sound in Australia?
Absolutely perfect.
Really?
It couldn't sound any better than it does.
Really?
And maybe that's just me being being so happy that you're back, but it sounds perfect.
You mean there's not even room for improvement?
Oh, there could never be any more room for improvement. You've hit the bar straight to the top, running out of the gates.
Oh, that's wonderful. Now that we are back, Andy, and you know, we've got this world of things that we can talk about, what would you like discussed?
Well, I think a lot of people are going to say the usual things, but I've got something different. You did a subject years and years ago on feral humans.
Oh, yes.
I think that's an interesting topic. I don't know who is out there that knows anything about it, but if you can find that guy again. And then there's the guy you had about the emotions of plants. I always found that to be a fascinating topic.
The emotions of plants. I remember that, and I remember, of course, feral humans. Frankly, a lot of people who really aren't feral are acting pretty feral. Have you noticed that?
Oh, yeah, that's always been the case. You look at any war zone or any rough neighborhood.
I don't know, man. I don't think there's been the kind of evil represented by ISIS. Well, sure, there has. There were the Nazis. There's always been really big evil. But it seems to me that ISIS is, you know, trying to set a record or something.
Oh, definitely.
But you're talking about real feral humans, as in, I don't know, let's say somebody born and raised by wild animals in the forest.
Exactly. And I believe there's been documented cases of it throughout history or recent history. So I'm wondering if this still happens.
It's a very good question you raise. I don't know. There was a movie. What, can you remember the name of that? It was about a little feral girl, I believe.
The only one I can think of is The Jungle Book, that Disney movie.
No, not that one. Somebody will come along and suggest it. There is a movie about a feral girl, and she was something, really something. So, sure, I'd be glad to work on that. Any other thoughts?
No, I'm just so happy you're back. I love open lines, so do as many open lines and special open lines as you can do. And it's good to have you back.
Okay, I'm thinking open lines every Friday and when a guest particularly disappoints. and that's something that I want everybody to know. You know, there's no way it's going to be out of the ballpark every night. It's going to be some wins, a few hits, and every now and then some losses. It's just the way it goes.
So, well, I'm sure there'll be many, many hits, many more than losses. So,
I hope you're right.
Back.
All right, buddy. Thank you so very much, and take care.
Thank you.
What in the world happens to the time? Anyway, you're listening to Midnight in the Desert Test Show Night, and that's all we're doing is testing. I'm Art Bell. Black, thick lines through all the stuff that you actually really want to read and learn about. And hello, Redacted.
Well, it's a fine evening to go for a ride, Art.
It is. It is. Now, you're an unknown. People don't know anything about you except perhaps the people on Belgab, and even the people on Belgab really don't know a whole lot, do they?
I hope not, and I hope to keep it that way. I like to remain mysterious.
Yes, I love mysterious. And I have heard people ask you for all kinds of things, what you look like.
Mm-hmm.
Requested pictures of you with, you know, little to nothing on. That always gets a big no. So you're going to remain a mystery, and you're going to do some open lines with me is what it comes down to. Do you want to explain as much about yourself as, well, I don't know, you're willing to say?
I think information about me is not important. I think that you're here and that the lines are open is the most important thing to keep in mind this evening.
That's true. It is, really. In other words, we learn nothing. There is one thing you should know, and that is that, oh my God, I see something that says Netscape calling. That's like a blast from the past. Probably before you were born.
Time traveler calling Netscape. From 1993?
Yeah, I guess so. Anyway, that caught my attention. Sorry, I tend to look at shiny things and jump. What have you thought of the show, so far?
It has a great energy to it. I have to say there is a certain energy about this show tonight that 2 years ago just didn't seem to be present. And I love hearing everyone's excitement in their voice. Everyone is very happy to hear you and very happy to call you this evening with their topic ideas. I like the feral humans idea.
I wonder if there are any more feral humans. And that means ones that have never seen society, never caressed an iPhone.
Never walked into a store or held money in their hand. It is a big planet, Art, and there's got to be places that civilization hasn't touched.
Well, they claim Bigfoot's still out there, right?
They do, and some people even claim that Bigfoot could be Neanderthal, mm-hmm. maybe.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. All right, let's do it. Brighton, Michigan, I believe you are on Midnight. Hello.
Hi, thank you. This is Nathan. I'm actually from Austin, Texas.
Are you really?
Yes.
See, I've got a phone, and it sort of identifies where people are, and trust me when I tell you, it says Brighton, Michigan.
Well, I believe it. I'm actually from there, so that's why my cell phone says that.
Well, then you've got a really smart cell phone. So he remembers where you were born or something. Cool. Welcome to the program.
Thank you. I just want to say, for start, it's an honor to speak to you.
Oh, thank you. It's an honor to speak to you, too. Now, we've got all that out of the way. We're kind of asking people two questions tonight. One is, do we sound okay?
You sound great. You sound fantastic.
So it's clear and all that stuff.
Yeah, I'm listening on my earphones, and you sound great.
Okay. The second question is, what would you like to see this program talk about? Favorite topic?
My favorite topic is near-death experiences. And I'm particularly interested in the negative near-death experiences. I know you had a few people on it back on the old show, and those were great.
People are afraid to come on the air and talk about negative near-death experiences, but I'm sure there are many, many more than people would admit. I mean, if you had a really negative one and you saw, the horned one or whatever, you'd be reviewing your life, and I don't know, maybe it's a good thing. I mean, maybe it's showing you that. Remember the movie Flatliners? You ever see that?
Yes, sir.
Ooh, they had lots of negative stuff.
Yeah, that was a good movie. I also just want to say happy anniversary to my wife at work. I know she's listening.
What is your wife's name?
Her name's Melissa.
Melissa? Happy, yes. Happy Melissa. There you heard it. On the air, nationwide, worldwide. Your own husband saying happy anniversary. How long have you been married?
Wait.
How long?
2 years.
2 years. Call me back in a year.
Okay, yes, sir.
See you later. Any comments redacted?
I love the idea of hearing about negative near-death experiences. Those are the stories that you don't ever hear. I've heard a lot of stories about the light, and I heard you mention maybe that's not the place to go to. Mm. Maybe that's not the direction to head. I would like to hear these stories that people don't want to tell about their negative or outside of the normal near-death experiences.
Okay.
People don't want to tell about their negative or outside of the normal near-death experiences.
Okay. Let me try and do something here. Let's see if I can do this. I can't resist. This person's name is Netscape.
Hello, Art. Can you hear me?
I hear you, Netscape. How did you pick that out, for goodness sakes?
I'm not at liberty to say. It's been something I've been involved with for a while, but I heard you talking about it, and just hearing you say my name on the air, that gave me kind of a rush. I'm really glad to have you back.
Where are you calling from, Netscape?
I can't reveal too much about my location, but I am calling from, I want to say, a couple miles off the coast of Guam right now.
Guam? Really? Wait a minute, off the coast of Guam?
Yeah, it's complicated. Just leave it at that.
Can I guess?
Sure.
You're in the Navy?
No.
No.
I did work with some people in the military, though.
Huh. No, I'm puzzled. You're in a private craft, then? Surely you're not swimming, right?
Oh, no.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not too good of a swimmer. But, yeah, private craft, you could say that.
All right. Private craft a couple of miles off of Guam. And I bet you can't reveal how you're making this call either, can you?
I'm using Skype, actually.
Well, yeah, I got that much. But, I mean, so you're getting internet from Guam?
Yes.
I was on Guam not all that long ago, and I have a few things to say about Guam. Number one, it's really expensive.
Yeah, it can be.
But
yeah, I just, you know, you've heard this already. I just wanted to say, on behalf of myself and everybody around the world, we're so glad that you're back on the air, and it's an honor to be talking to you right now, actually.
Guam is where America starts its day. Are you familiar with that phrase?
Yes, I am.
Redacted, anybody to ask on the anything to ask this fellow, the other side of the world?
I'm very curious about whatever top secret mission that he's on right now, but it sounds like if he revealed those details, it might get him into trouble, I'll leave it alone. But it is good to hear from you.
Thank you. I'm really, like I said before, I'm really happy that, you know, you decided to accept my call. I've been trying to call for, 20 minutes now, but, you know, I'm really jazzed to be talking to you right now.
You don't know Jazz, do you? Fellow named Jazz?
No, I don't.
Can I ask you one thing, Netscape?
Yes.
Are you, in fact, calling from 2015, or are you calling from 1993? Are you a time traveler calling from another time?
Nope, I'm calling from 2015, but it is interesting that you would say something like that. And it's also interesting, you were talking about the United States drought, you know, and all that. I just wanted to say, we've got plenty of water over here, you know, lots of room. If you guys just want to, you know, hang out or move, plenty of water to go around.
Well, if you want to subsidize my cost of living on Guam, that would be fine. Let me tell you a little story. I took a taxi cab from my hotel to the only grocery store that I think is in Guam, and it was like $110.
Yeah, that makes sense. But
in what universe?
Well, you know, costs go up the farther you get away from the United States when you're still, you know, inside a quote-unquote United States territory.
Boy, ain't that the truth. All right, brother, thank you very, very much, and I don't know, take care out there. The seas can get rough.
I'm fine.
All right, well, thank you, Netscape.
Good talking to you, Art. Right. See you later.
Take care. You know, I actually was a Netscape fan. I had Netscape all over my computer. Loved Netscape. I hope I didn't cut you off. Did I, Redacted? Oh, goodness, I think I did. See, that's a problem. I've got to figure that one out. That's one for the books, too. I'm going to have to figure this out. How to get redacted, how to hang up on a caller without hanging up on Redacted. Redacted,
oh,
are you, you're back, right?
Back.
I'm sorry, you know, like I... You went away when he went sailing. So to
test speak. Show. That's why we do the test show.
Yeah, it'll probably be this way for some time until I figure out what the heck I'm doing. Let's go to our, let's go to Skype over here and say, is it RK or is it, who's on the line? Midnight, you're on the air, whoever you are. I did answer a line. I think they went away. Let's try Andrew Jackson. Great president.
Hello.
Okay, extinguish your device, please. No, turn it off.
Hello?
There you go. Hi.
Hey.
Hey.
There's
Can you hear me?
I do. I hear you fine.
Okay. I hear something. Oh, hold on. I have to pause the live stream.
Yes, that's what I said. Extinguish your device.
That there means... we go.
Yes,
there
okay. Go. Very good.
Wow, Art. It is a very sincere pleasure to talk to you. Remember, I'm 20 years old. I'm calling from New York.
Okay. And by the way, you're on with Redacted.
Good morning to you, Redacted. And by the way, Roswell's to you, Art.
Thank you.
How do I sound coming through on my end?
You sound wonderful. Are you using a headphone mic?
I'm using a, it's called a Blue Snowball. It's a stand microphone.
Absolutely awesome, I would say.
And I'm coming through on Skype.
Right. Redacted, he said hi to you and you didn't say anything.
I did. I said good evening, and he does sound great.
Okay.
good evening, Roswell's to you as well.
See, the good evening didn't come through, so maybe that's another fault of some sort.
Well, one of the things that I always loved you did back when you were on Coast to Coast was the Ghost to Ghost.
Oh, well, this year, you know what you can expect?
What?
Ghost to Ghost Digital.
Amazing.
Oh, it will be.
And I have a little experience that was very Ghost to Ghost related. I've never found a solution to this, and maybe someone else can explain it if you'd like to hear it.
Yes.
When I was born, I was baptized in a greenhouse, and I was baptized a little bit late. And right as the water was put over my head, the glass above my head in the greenhouse shattered.
Wow.
And it was a family priest, my aunt, uncle, my mother, my father. There are a lot of to this day, we can't figure it out.
Well, it has some sort of deep meaning. What sort of life have you led?
I've decided to stay out of college just because I'm one of four siblings, two of which have six-figure debts. So I'm working now. I have a retail job.
Hmm. Have you had evil thoughts?
I wouldn't say so. I've had very entrepreneurial, aspirational thoughts. I look up to people like Mark Cuban and... You know, I love the show Shark Tank, and I love your show. I listen to it late at night. It helps me fall asleep. I love all the old broadcasts.
Uh-huh. Your entrepreneurial thoughts don't include, like, stomping on people on the way up, do they?
I wouldn't say so. I would say creating an atmosphere where everybody can enjoy themselves and work toward creating a better environment just for everyone.
That sounds very positive. I mean, with a beginning like that, I would be, well, concerned that at some moment you may turn.
Oh, well, I certainly hope not.
Well, I hope not, too. Redacted, any questions?
I'm just curious if he's ever had any other windows around him spontaneously shatter or any other interesting paranormal experiences that you can't explain.
Yeah, good.
I did have one significant dream, which was very sort of unexplainable. There was a highlight of it, you know, the mandala with Jung, Carl Jung. There was one dream significantly. I remember coming up, going down into the ocean and coming up to the surface in a mandala, and I could manipulate it with my hands.
Really?
And I can move around the colors with my hands. And then I burst up through it, and there was a lot of other things in that dream. I have a dream journal that I've been keeping for quite a few years. Dreams have always been very interesting to me.
Dreams are interesting. I don't know if they have meaning. I think some of them do, and others may be, you know, forecasting something in your future.
Sounds like a very powerful soul we have on the line here.
I would agree with that. All right.
I'm feeling that vibration. Thank you very much.
Are
Thank you?
You
very much.
I'm glad. All right. Well, we're going to, I think, take a break here. And I can't thank you enough for calling. I really do appreciate it.
Thank you so much for taking my call. Everything sounds great. And I can't wait to continue on listening. And maybe I'll be able to call in the future.
All right, my friend. Good night. Redacted, say good night.
Good night.
All right. So we will be back shortly with more of whatever it is we're doing. It's sort of a test show. And we want to know how we sound. We want to know what you want us to talk about on the program and so forth. I'm Art Bell. Midnight in the Desert. Underway. Finally. Isn't this an awesome, awesome piece of music? It's just, I don't know, it just kind of rolls along beautifully and it relaxes you and energizes you, and I love music. I could not have done this show without music. How about you, Redacted? How do you feel about music?
I think it sets the tone beautifully, and your selections are always perfect for the moment, and it wouldn't be the same without the right music. It just would not be the same show.
You know, when we were talking about the show, back when we were sort of dreaming, you know, Keith and I were talking about it, Keith, I've got to have the music. And we started looking into it, and the music cost millions of dollars, it seemed like. I mean, it was just, it was unbelievable. So we've got the music. Anyway, let's go back to the lines and see what we meet up with. You're Midnight, you're on the air. Hi.
Hello there.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm just fine. You sound like a very young guy or a gal. I think you're a gal, aren't you?
Yes. My name's Michelle.
Hi, Michelle.
And I'm calling from right outside of Bismarck, North Dakota, listening on 5085. I think it's the
WCAG. Wait a minute.
Shortwave.
We're on shortwave.
Yes.
I didn't know they were going to carry the test show. How cool is that?
Pretty cool. I was excited. It comes in really good here.
Oh, that's wonderful.
That is great news.
And what kind of radio are you listening on?
It's a little sea crane radio I picked up online.
Yes, that's where you can get them, sea crane, no doubt about it. Congratulations. You are, Michelle, our first shortwave caller.
Yeah, I'm working overnight, and I like to have my sea crane with me so I can pick up some interesting stuff to listen to while I have to work.
Well, let me tell you, there's not a lot left on shortwave, hon. You know, most of it is religious-based now. There's not too much out there, you know, like what we're doing.
I know. Well, this station I listen to quite a bit. They have music.
Oh, I know they do.
You know, on the evenings.
You want to hear what my big worry is, Michelle?
What?
Well, they do have a lot of religion from time to time. At least many shortwave stations do, because it pays a bill, you know? And I'm frankly a little worried, because sometimes we talk about things on this show that, well, might not be met well by a religious audience, if you follow.
Maybe, but I just think that... You know, the diversity is better for the listeners that like to listen to shortwave.
Well, I believe that. Redacted, and what do you think? This is your first shortwave appearance, Redacted.
Well, I appreciate Michelle calling in to let us know that we're on shortwave, but there will be some shows in the future that Art will have to add a warning ahead of time, and that's how you'll know it's going to be a good one.
Yeah, she's right. Some shows that I have, like EVPs, you know, ghost voices and things like that, I do warn people.
I love that stuff.
You do? You love it?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Just wait till you hear it, how it sounds coming over shortwave. It's going to knock your socks off, Michelle.
Oh, yeah. I listen to the station all the time because I think Ted Randall has music, and now with you, I'll just keep it here.
All right. Michelle, you have made my night, dear. Thank you.
Thank you.
And listen, wait, one more thing. Is there anything you really want to hear us concentrate on hard?
I like ghost stuff myself, but, you know, like when you do the Halloween stuff and all.
Ghost to ghost digital.
And, of course, like I know Father Malachi Martin passed away, but I agree with the guy that I called in earlier. I like.
All right.
I like when you had him on.
All right. Thank you very much. Redacted, do you remember Father Malachi Martin?
Oh, I do very clearly. His stories about the perfectly possessed
right.
would make my blood run cold, but I couldn't stop listening.
Well, he had a point. Have you ever, like, walked down the street of a big city and you've seen somebody who, I don't know, they almost look soulless when you look at them?
Cold, dead yeah. eyes, yet determined look on their face, and you instinctively just step aside to get out of their way. Yes, I've seen those people.
Like shark eyes.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Cold, dead, and black.
And I would run Father Malachi Martin's voice through my mind and wonder if that was one of them.
Well, I do believe they're out there. One of the things we're going to be doing, Redacted, and pretty quick, too, is looking for a witch. And when I say witch, just the way I used to say it, I want a magic-dispensing, cauldron-stirring, broom-riding...
Spell-casting.
Spell-casting, all of that, yes. I want it all. So we're going to try to find another witch. And I am so sorry that... hours passed away. Evelyn Paglini was quite a person.
She's one of a kind.
Well, I hope not. I hope we can find one. All right, Redacted, stay right where you are. Once again, we're back with Redacted. Redacted, welcome back. Did you hear that newscast, Redacted?
About head transplants?
Well, there was that, yes, and that's worthy of a question or two, but also about the people who thought they had a non-human child.
Yes.
With soulless black eyes.
I think I'm still mentally processing that one.
It causes me to think, when I get into open lines, I want some woman to call me who thinks she's got a non-human child of the...
Yes.
Black-eyed, soulless variety.
Yes, and do tell us all about it. And if even possible, I don't know if this would be possible, but even put the black-eyed child on the line.
Ew, I don't know about that. Presumably a black-eyed, soulless child probably wouldn't talk to us, or worse yet, they might.
I'd like to find out.
You know, I did once have a woman call who, see, here we go. This is where the shortwave will start to have a problem. She wanted to go to hell, and she wanted to take her child with her. Do you recall that?
Harlot the Witch.
Yeah. Oh, you've got a good memory. You really do. That, to me, was, I don't know, one of the more disturbing things I think I've ever heard. I mean, how could any mother ever say anything like that?
She was determined. There was no way to shake her from what she wanted to do. That was it. She was going to make sure that her child served the devil.
That's right. That's right. It utterly freaked me out. Let me add somebody here. We'll try this. Blackhorn, I think it is. Hello?
Blackthorn. Hey, Art. Welcome back.
Blackthorn, thank you very much. Blackthorn, you're going to have to extinguish your device.
Okay.
Okay, good. Now, where are you?
Okay, I am in Canberra, Australia.
Canberra, Australia. Really? You know, yes. I guess we're getting a lot of Australian calls because we're actually on at a fairly decent time for Australia versus Europe, huh?
It is great. It's 3:41 in the afternoon.
In the afternoon,
here.
Yeah.
Yeah. So my wife and I moved here from Wilmington, North Carolina, about 3 months ago.
Right.
So we love Australia. It's a wonderful country, and the people are great too.
Well, then I pose the same question to you. Should everybody? I mean, you did have a policy at one time in Australia where, boy, we've got this big immigration thing going on in America. But you know, you welcomed people in Australia. Because I guess it's a big country and you needed population, right?
Yes, but see, we're expats. We're Americans. So
oh, you're Americans.
I'm not totally sure about what their policies were before.
Okay. Well, even we started pretty much as a prison country, I think.
Yeah.
I know you guys did. Yes.
Hey, I just want to tell you. Man, I remember I was living in Seattle in like 95 going to school, and I was delivering medications to nursing homes at night. Mm-hmm. And I would drive around an old truck from this pharmacy delivering, and you were like the first person that got me into like talk radio. And I would listen to you all the time. And it's so good to hear you back on the air. I know that I speak probably everyone who's listening, that they're just like when your bumper music came on at the first of the hour,
yes.
your record theme music, and then you played ABBA, and then you played all your other songs that are just like every time I hear them on the radio or I play them, I think of Art Bell. It's just all these memories are flooding back. Aww. All those nights I listened to you, I fell asleep. I couldn't wait for the next night to hear what you had to talk about, you know, whether it was reptilians or whatever, you know, the whole gamut of issues. Just, it's just so good to have you back.
Well, thank you so very much. I try to treat the paranormal seriously. I really do. I think it's a serious subject. And good Lord, if we didn't have stuff to talk about that you can't prove with science, and you can't prove because you can't touch it. If we couldn't talk about that stuff, would it be such an interesting world? I don't think so.
Yeah, you're right. You're right. But I do have one interest.
Yes.
I remember, though, I'm not sure how this ever resolved or if it ever was carried out, but I remember you had a guest at one time, and he was talking about trees and organic objects that could record voices and sound in a room.
Okay.
And that there was... that over time the voices would like kind of imprint themselves into their organic material.
Oh yeah,
and then
you
might be able to pull them back out again, almost like a record player. You know, like you just kind of pull the imprint out and play it.
Oh, actually, I think it's true, and there are people doing research into that, and they've made actually some progress. So I've got to find a guest on that. It's true. In other words, the couch, the chair, the windows, especially the windows, may have a memory, you know, kind of like if this bed could tell a story.
yeah.
All right.
Well, Art, I know a lot of other people want to get through. Just wanted to welcome you back. It's so good to hear your voice, and thank you for coming back.
All right. Thank you, my friend. I'm going to hang up now, and I hope it doesn't dump Redacted. So, Redacted, are you there? Aw. See? Why is it doing that? Somebody has to teach me how I hang up on an additional caller that I've got on Skype. I can add them, no problem, but then somehow Redacted gets hung up on. Redacted, are you back?
Yes, this is the joy of live radio.
Okay. So you tell me. Maybe you're... somebody just said you need to remove from...
Stand by, everyone. We'll try and get Art back. I guess he got a little digitally disconnected there. So we're going to try to reconnect. Maybe the thunderstorms came in.
The connection wasn't that great either. You were cutting in and out.
Something happened all of a sudden, huh?
It did. It made me worry.
Boy, made me worry too. Let me try Tingle Pod. You're not going to... I'm not going to listen to that. I don't know what that was, but I'm not going to listen to it. Lewis, hello. Lewis?
Yeah.
Hi there, Lewis. Please turn off your device and welcome to the program.
I'm so sorry. Art, can you hear me?
Well, I hear you, but you're...
Oh, we're losing them again. The feared thunderstorms.
So apparently we're having some kind of difficulty that we were not sure about. That makes me afraid to answer anything else. I'll answer a call because we know the phones probably will work. Hello? No, I guess not. So apparently we are not online. So I actually have no way of knowing if I'm on the air right now. I'm told I'm on the air. Okay. But everything I pick up appears not to be happening. Let's go to Santa Rosa, California. Hello? Santa Rosa, California. Are you on the air? No, it appears you're not. So something is definitely going on. Something that... No, we're not really having thunderstorms. Let me see if I can get redacted. Oh, no, how about...
You've got me.
I've got you.
Yes.
Okay. That was an odd set of circumstances.
It is.
This is beginning to sound like the Area 51 call. But you sound fine now, redacted.
Good. I'm glad. And I just hope that we can get more callers on the line.
Well, we can. Look, everybody in the world is calling. I've got calls you wouldn't believe. I'm going to try and answer one. And Randy. Randy, are you there?
Yes, I'm here.
Hi, Randy. Where are you?
Hi, Art. I'm up in Bend, Oregon, in the higher desert here. And you're sounding great.
Well, until a few moments ago, what did you hear?
Well, I'll tell you what's been going on because I've been listening to the whole show. There's a lot of buffering going on where you'll drop out and then you'll come back on again.
Really?
But I know it's not my end because my Skype phone kept ringing, so I knew I wasn't loose. At first, I thought it was my internet connection maybe going down.
Yes.
But it seems like there's a lot of buffering, and I switched between the two listening. There's two different ways to listen to the show, and I switched to the secondary one, and it seemed to work better.
What is your secondary?
Let me see. What was it? What were they called here? Let me see if I could see them on here. I listened on the pop-up player, and that seemed to be better than the tune-in radio.
Okay.
The tune-in radio was dropping out a little faster.
Here's what's going on, I think. Mm-hmm. We've got a lot of people listening. And so it may be that the streaming companies are not quite set up for the amount of, you know, in and out traffic we're getting or whatever. This is exactly why we're doing this program right now, so that if we, you know, run into this sort of problem, we can do something about it.
Well, that's why I wanted to call in and see how am I sounding good there. I'm on an RE15 microphone with a mixer and an equalizer and all that.
Oh, gosh,
you just sound
pretty good.
Great.
Yeah. You sound like you're sitting right here.
Well, I have a whole broadcasting out of here on the podcast and is Skype. I mean, it really is. It's just a matter of, like you said, getting enough bandwidth to keep it running and not have it go down like that.
Right. Well, you actually began to break up a little bit during that last paragraph you gave us. So, you know, I don't know what's going on. We live in this new day and age where weird things happen, I guess.
Yeah, well, it's, you know, I spent a lot of time in the news business and 20 years I'm pretty technically oriented, so I know all this equipment can get, especially with what you're doing, switching over to going to the internet.
Cause right.
I mean, I come from way back in the day when we had radio and real radio stations.
Right.
To be on the internet like this.
Yeah, you said you spent years in news.
Right. Yeah. I ended up with NBC Nightly News out in Los Angeles is where I finished up my career. And by the 1990s, right before the OJ stuff started, and I wanted out of it by then, it was turned into tabloid for me. And
yeah,
so
that's exactly.
20 years in the picture industry.
Can you hear me?
Yeah,
that's what I want to ask you about, that what's the way news has changed. I know I'll get criticized. I watch CNN, and I don't know what's happened to those people. Honest to God, I don't know what's happened. Do you have any view on that?
Well, you know, with the whole Brian Williams scandal at NBC, it's not, it's not hard to point out where it started to go. It started to turn tabloid back in the late 80s, early 90s, and they started to create the news, and that's what it's become. It's just everyone out there trying to one-up the next one, and it doesn't matter if the facts are there or not. And I was in the news business because I was always searching for the truth, you know. It was always about the truth. It doesn't matter about the truth.
It kind of feels... really awful. Yeah, it's awful. And I wonder if it's going to get worse. What do you think?
Well, I think it will get worse before it gets better, and then you have the internet, which you can't believe anything. You don't know where it's coming from and what's real or not real, and that's why I'm glad you're back on the air here, because at least your show puts it out there and lets everybody make up their own mind, and that's what the news used to be. It was about presenting the facts and just putting it out there and let the people make up their mind. And now if you watch the news, you see people on there that are their analysts, they call them. And that's them bending the story the way they want to feed it to you. So you really have to know what you're listening to when you watch the or listen to the news now.
Well, you're dead on, Randy. Dead on. Yeah. I really want to thank you for calling the test show. Thank you.
Well, thank you, Art, for having me on, and hopefully we'll be talking again in the future.
All right. Take care, my friend. Redacted, do you have any comments on the news?
I think the news has become a big sensationalism circus, and it's more exciting to run a sensationalistic story than just provide the facts. The who, what, when, where, why, and how isn't so important anymore, and it's a shame that it isn't, because we just need the news to be the news, and it no longer is. It's become a circus that seemed to go downhill from hard copy.
I agree. I agree completely. All right. Hazleton, Pennsylvania, I believe you're on the air.
Yeah. Hi, Art. How are you?
I'm fine. You're also on with Redacted.
Good evening.
Okay. Hello, good afternoon, good evening, good afternoon, whatever time zone you're in. I'm so glad I got through.
That's the sound of internet trouble, is what that is.
I hear you fine. Can you still hear me?
Yeah, I do. I do now.
Okay. I said you knew where I was. Why? Because of the caller ID, I guess, right?
Yes. Yes, I do have some rudimentary caller ID here, so yes.
Yes. I talked to you once before. I got through a long time ago when you were on Westwood One yet. And it's an honor to talk to you again, and thank you for coming back. This is great. You have charisma on the air like no other broadcaster.
Well, thank you.
I've never heard anyone, and it's nothing that you're trying to put on. It's natural, and I think that's why it works. But I don't know of anyone else that even has it. I mean, you either have it or you don't, and you just have it. I mean, when I listen to you, I feel like you're someone I've known for years.
That's a great compliment. You know, I know I've got something, but I, honest to God, I don't know what it is. I really don't. I guess I am me on the air, and you've got. My answer has to be I don't know, just me.
Well, don't worry about it, because it works. Just, you know, I mean, I think if you had to try to think about it, and if you tried to analyze it, it wouldn't happen.
All right, buddy, I've got to run. I'm right up against the top of the hour, but thank you so very much.
Thank you very much, Doc. Keep up the good work.
You have a good night.
You too, man. Bye bye.
Bye bye. Well, all right. We appear to be having internet difficulties. Undefined as yet. We do have a lot of thunderstorms in the area. I just took a look at the radar, and something's going on out there. And that may be disrupting things for us. I'm not entirely sure yet, but that's why we're doing a test show, so we can figure this kind of thing out. Redacted, by any chance, are you still with us?
I am still with you
okay.
For the moment. It does seem intermittent. I hope it doesn't drop out at a critical moment.
Boy, I hope not, too. As I mentioned, we do have thunderstorms sort of all over the area. Anybody wanting to look up, my zip code is 89048, so you can look at the radar yourself, and you'll see them all over the place. I'm not sure that's why this is happening, but we're just going to continue on ahead. What the heck? See what happens. So, let's see. Tazar, really? What a name. Tazar. Hello, Tazar. Are you there? Wait a minute. Let me get this up.
Hey
Tazar. How are you?
Can you hear me?
I sort of hear you.
All right. I'm using a headphone, or, you know, a headset on my computer. I'm using Skype.
Okay.
Columbus, Ohio.
Okay. Be sure and turn off your device as you talk to us.
It is off.
All right.
So I had a big list of things I'd like to hear now that you're back on the air. I just found you kind of recently, maybe about 6 years ago. So I'm listening to all your reruns, but it's nice to actually have you live.
Oh, yes. It sounds like you're shifting all around there.
I guess I'm just moving on the chair, but if you can hear that. I'd like to hear, do you still have Madman Markham? Are you still in contact with him?
It's interesting. You should ask. Yes. I am in contact with Madman. I talked to him. I saved his number, you know, and I called him about 3 weeks ago now. And Madman is planning a bigger, better, I don't know if the word is better, but a bigger time machine. And if he doesn't fry himself alive, we'll try and get him on the air.
We've got to hear that. That'd be great.
The last I heard, he made a couch disappear from the warehouse he was building time machines in.
Oh, and you know, I hadn't heard that. Seriously? Yeah.
Yes, he made an entire couch disappear, and there were other people in the room that saw that the couch was no longer there.
Can I ask, well, I guess I can't, redacted, where'd this information come from?
I think it's better to ask Mr. Madman when he's on the air with
you. Okay, all right.
I look forward to that.
Yeah, I'd say. If he made a couch disappear, God, I wonder where it is now.
I want to know where she's getting her information.
Yeah, me too. But, you know, the name Redacted tells you all.
Yeah, I guess we won't know. Are we ever going to hear your Ouija board story?
No.
Okay.
No. No, that's one thing I just won't talk about, but the Ouija board really is one of those things. I'm sorry, it's just...
Are you aware of the tool song that uses a clip from your Area 51 caller?
Oh, yes, yes.
That's how I found you, so I didn't know if you've ever mentioned that or not, so I actually did research. I found out it was Art Bell. I didn't know who the heck Art Bell was. And that's how I found all your reruns, and that's what finally brought me over to you guys. So, awesome.
Yes, my friend, I was familiar with the Tool song, and it was a great honor that they used it.
Yeah, did you know before it was released, or did you find out after the fact?
I was on the big network, right, and I think that I heard that they wanted to use it or asked permission to use something. So, and then I kind of forgot about it. And then, boom, it came out and shocked me.
Awesome. Yeah, I was just curious how that went down.
Yep.
And then any chance you could ever get in touch with Lorena McKenna and interview her?
Would love to. I absolutely would love to.
I don't know what she's up to, and I think if you could get her on here and...
Sorry to say a little bit, but thank you very, very much for calling. Let's try Halifax, Nova Scotia. Hello? Yeah, we're trying on the lines here, on the phone lines. Halifax, Nova Scotia. Are you there? No? Let's try Winnipeg, Manitoba. Winnipeg, are you there? No. Let's try Florida. Brooksville, Florida, I think it is. Hello?
Yes, hello, Art. This is Michael Smith in Spring Hill, Florida. Ooh, I made a boo-boo.
Yeah, you shouldn't give me your last name. Let's just go with your first name only.
Hi, Art?
Yes.
Hi, it's Scott in San Diego. I am really surprised, gobsmacked even, that I got in. What with the gremlins in the system tonight, but you're sounding good.
Well, we certainly were up until whatever happened. I'm not sure what happened.
Well, I was the first 2 hours, I was initially listening on TuneIn, and then I found the other sites, the ACC feed that would go through my old vintage Mac on the iTunes, and you're coming in loud and clear on that.
Okay, good.
So, except for the bugaboos, we're doing okay, I guess.
Okay, well, you know, it is the test show. Now, yes, we may be getting information here that is rather disturbing about who knows, so we'll just have to see how it holds up.
Okay, if you're still taking ideas, I've got a couple of ideas for the future.
Fire away.
Okay. When I was 9 years old, President Kennedy was killed, That's always a topic of interest for me. Also, general metaphysical things, psychics and the like. But I know you don't really get into politics, but, you know, we talk about otherworldly stuff, and we're living in the real world, so-called, and politics, by and large, has done a bang-up job of royally screwing up a lot of people and places and things in the real world.
Boy,
somehow
sure
you
has.
Need to bring those two things together, how the metaphysical might, on an individual-by-individual basis, put us in a frame of mind and a frame of spirit and inspire us to change some of the stuff that has been going wrong for so long.
Well, I don't know why I'm going to ask you this, but I'm going to ask you, since you brought up politics, what do you think of the Donald?
Oxygen is precious, and I'd rather not waste any of it talking about
him. I guess that tells us.
Would get you knocked off internet and maybe the shortwave station, so I better hold my tongue.
Okay, well, listen, I honestly appreciate your call so very much. Thank you, and don't waste any more oxygen. How about you, Redacted? Still there?
Yes, and I think he's right.
Well, I'm going to ask you anyway. I mean, he is... Do you know when he first came on, the Donald was really, really interesting. I mean, not that I was necessarily going to vote for him, but I thought he was really interesting. I asked Dr. J, my producer, if he would be kind enough to try and get the Donald on. Well, of course, you know, he's still working on that. And now the McCain thing. John McCain was shot down by the North Vietnamese. It looks like to me the Donald shot himself down.
He's not very popular. He's become kind of a character, almost, they say, a parody. Once you become a parody of yourself,
yes,
you've kind of gone downhill, and I think he's definitely become a parody of himself. He's a character, and, you know, I can't see someone like him holding a serious political position.
Actually... he may have done, and it's going to be, you know, right now, tomorrow may change all that, but right now he leads over on the Republican side, the whole pack.
Really?
Oh, you didn't know that?
No, I'm completing top secret missions all the time, and I don't have as much time to listen to the news as I used to.
He's ahead of the pack now. He's actually ahead of Bush.
Ahead of Bush?
Yeah, ahead of Bush. Ahead of every other of the 1,000 Republicans that are running.
Well, it really makes one wonder what will happen if he's in charge.
It makes one wonder about a lot of stuff.
It does. It does. It makes me a little bit nervous to think about him in charge.
All right, let's try and go back to the lines here, and I'm going to give this a shot. Hello, probably somewhere in Asia. Hello?
Wait a minute.
I'm waiting.
Hello?
Yes, hello?
Hi, this is Charlie.
Charlie, where are you, Charlie?
I'm in Thailand.
Thailand?
All the way from
sure.
Thailand.
Oh, yeah. What a dreamy place Thailand must be.
Laid back in Thailand, and I have been fighting for 2 hours to get my system to contact you.
Well, your system has made it.
Thank you. I'm so excited that you're back on the air.
Thank you. It's certainly good to be here. We're, you know, kind of moving through the bugs and the problems tonight and trying to figure out what's going on. But in general, it seems to be working. Are you able to hear most of the show?
No. No, it's just spotty now and then. I've been fighting with the internet connection locally, and then the internet starts to work, and I start to make the other parts work, and then it stops again. So I've been screaming at my provider, a sweet little Thai girl who has to listen to me complain on the telephone to her to try to get my internet working. But I've got a quick one that I did hear at the very beginning. A gentleman phoned in. Actually, I'm giving him benefit of the doubt, but a gentleman phoned in.
Yes.
And asked about redacted. Can you tell me?
You know, Charlie, I doubt she can because you were breaking up during that whole last part. So ask redacted the question again, if you would, please.
Oh, yes. Actually, to both of you, I think I heard at the very beginning a gentleman telephoned in, you know, who are sterile, human beings who are sterile. Is that correct?
He was asking about feral with an F, F-E-R-A-L, humans.
Well, okay. Well, that mixes my response. Yeah, I thought he was talking about sterility as in cannot have babies.
No, we're referring to wild humans that have never had any contact with civilization. Have you ever heard about anyone like that?
Not personally, no. You know, I've seen The Wild Child from France, but the movie.
Mm-hmm.
But what I was going to contribute anyway is that the Hindus and some of the Buddhists have a practice that they practice so that the male person will, can I say ejaculate?
You can.
Okay, into their bladder instead of out. And the goal is to save the precious bodily fluids, to save the energy that would be expended and actually donated to the yoni, to the female. And I was thinking about that because I thought I heard sterility.
I see. Well,
so there's a topic for you, another century.
Another century, indeed. I think that Thailand is, by and large, Buddhist, is it not?
About 99%.
99%. Wow. Have you found yourself, living in that environment, moving toward a Buddhist philosophy?
Oh, I was a Buddhist before I got here. I took Buddhist refuge from His Holiness the Dalai Lama. So I'm very, very lucky to be... to have him as my root guru. And I also took Bodhisattva vows while I was there. It was very fortuitous.
Have you ever had an audience with His Holiness the Dalai Lama?
No, I have met him three times, but it was not a sit-down audience.
Mm-hmm. Still very fortunate.
Yeah, oh, it's wonderful. Actually, I got to ask him a question in the 1970s. He came to Dallas at the Dallas Thanksgiving Hall and gave a short talk along with some other people, and they said to open the question. So I was first to ask, and I stumped the Dalai Lama. And it's not something I'm particularly proud of, but I did it.
What was the question?
I asked His Holiness, what is the role or the function of, what is the role or function of study of aesthetics, the study of beauty, in the path to enlightenment?
Right.
And His Holiness looked up and thought, he looked down and thought, the crowd there, 20 or 30 people, were looking at me thinking I had hurt the Dalai Lama somehow because he delayed so long. And he finally said, I'll have to think about it. I don't know. And at the time, I thought it was a very easy question. But later, I've discovered it was a very difficult question.
Obviously. Wow, that's an amazing story. I really want to thank you for calling tonight, especially all the way from Thailand. That's an incredible call. Thank you.
Well, thank you for allowing me in, and as I say, I've been fighting 2 hours and 15 minutes to get the system here to respond.
Thank you for the fight. We'll look forward to hearing from you again.
Wonderful, Art, and Redacted. What a wonderful name.
Well, it's great to hear from you all the way from Thailand this evening.
All right. There we go. Redacted, now, are you still there? No. So, see, I haven't figured this out yet. For some reason, I should be able to hit something, you know, and keep Redacted on the line. Yes, I know. But no such option exists. Somebody in my ear just said, you need to remove from group. I'm well aware of that. I have no such option that's being offered. So, while I would love to remove from group and still keep Redacted, let me see if I can, get Redacted back on the line. Let's see. This is the whole point of this show. The absolute whole point of the show. And now I don't even see an option to call Redacted. So I'm going to pick up Drew and say hello, Drew.
Well, it's great to hear from you all the way.
Hey, Drew, would you please extinguish your device?
I will extinguish my device. How are you?
Very well, thank you.
All right, just made it. I just wanted to say, I started listening for about 2 hours now from the beginning, and within the last 30 minutes, just noticed the buffering and all that stuff. But otherwise, from Tokyo, Japan, you're coming in 5x9, as they say.
You're in Tokyo.
I'm in Tokyo, Japan. Today we have a holiday. Umi no Hi, you probably remember that, Ocean Day.
I do, and how is it celebrated?
I guess people go to the beach, because I don't particularly celebrate this holiday, because I'm taking a day off from work, and it just so happens that I just wanted to make a call, and then, well, actually, I really wanted to start off by doing the JC impression, but You got me, but I'm enjoying it so far.
I think we're probably likely, very likely, to get the real JC to call in. So I'm kind of glad you didn't do that.
Okay, because I wanted to start up by saying, you know, Mr. Bell, how dare you? Redacted, how dare you too? But I'm kind of excited here because, you know, the bumper music, just the whole feel, seriously, it's just bringing back, years ago for me.
Yes.
And then it's really a joy to hear you again.
Well, if we can keep things the way they ought to be, we'll be fine internet-wise, but that's where we're having trouble. Thank you very, very much for the call all the way from Japan. And we're going to take a break here and a very deep breath. I'm Art Bell. This is Midnight in the Desert. That we may have Redacted back, but we're looking at news coming up pretty shortly. Redacted, are you there?
I am here.
Oh, good. Oh, thank goodness you're there. I have no idea what's going on. The internet's getting kind of strange.
It's getting intermittent. It's really weird, and it's making me nervous for Midnight in the Desert.
It's making me nervous.
The thunderstorms?
You know, I'm going to look at the radar right now. But I don't think so. I mean, well, yeah, it could be. The radar is just a disastrous mess. There are storms all over the place. So it could be. It could be. Just so everybody knows, the way I get internet is this really wonderful new company called LasVegas.net. Brings high speed, high quality internet from Las Vegas over the mountain by microwave, and that's how I called earlier.
No, this is Redacted.
Redacted, no. I was talking about Halifax, Nova Scotia.
Do we have Halifax, Nova Scotia on the line?
Well, I thought I did. Louisville, Kentucky. How about you? Louisville, Kentucky.
Hello.
Hello.
Is this Art Bell?
It is.
Yes, well, this is Dave here in Southern Indiana, Kilo Bravo Niner.
Oh no! Kilo, don't give your call.
That's okay.
You're a ham.
Okay.
You're a ham.
Yeah. Nine land, and I'm just.
Oh, this is bad. Redacted, it sounds like we lost that call. Sounds like we lost Redacted. All right. Yep, we've lost Redacted. So, what are we going to do? What I think we should do is end the show for the evening, and because obviously we're just sort of in and out, in and out, in and out. So we're going to end the show. It's a test show, and so we're going to end the show for the night. And let me see. Let me do that. It's the only right thing to do. Nobody can hear anybody. It's just sort of a big mess out there. I'm sorry it's working out this way, folks, but that's why we did a test show, to see what would happen. So we'll end it here. Thank you all so very much. See you, I think, I hope, tomorrow evening for Midnight in the Desert.
In the desert.
I'm Art Bell. Have a good night.
Shooting stars across the sky.